Too many of us are looking to Dr. M to solve the nation's problems. Dare I say that sometimes I'm even a bit worried that some of the ministers who should be speaking up more clearly about their portfolios are waiting for the Prime Minister to say something. This is a bit worrying, although one understands many of them perhaps have never had ministerial roles, have always been in opposition. But, you know, why aren't they speaking up more, taking and relieving him of the burden of being the sole person? So I think then there's that. But then there's the other thing which I talk about in my book as well. But where are the people in the public who are willing to speak up? There are very few of us who speak up.
Well, some of us on the media do.
Some of you do, I agree. But, you know, that's your job. But where are the public intellectuals who speak? I'm no public intellectual, but I'm happy to come up here and speak, right? There are very few speak. Because in Malaysia, we have a culture of, my God, everything is sensitive, right? So you can't mention anything about race. You can't mention anything about religion. You can't mention about the incompetence of certain institutions. You can't mention the fact that corruption is still rife in many of the so-called professional circles. But those taboos, the inability to create an environment in which intellectuals, business leaders speak about it, does not allow for the government to transform. Has any business leader since the election spoken up about corruption?
Nada.
No, you know better than I do. I'm just asking. But as far as I know, none. Has anyone talked about the need for meritocracy in the GLCs? No one. I mentioned this 2 years ago at the Khazanah Mega Trends. There were all the GLC CEOs speaking about inclusion and this and that, etc. I said, how can the GLCs in Malaysia ever compete if there isn't meritocracy in the GLCs? And I asked them, do you believe there is meritocracy? And the answers I got were three quarters of the panel didn't want to reply, sensitive. And one or two who replied in 30 seconds basically said, we don't have such a problem. So, you know, hocus pocus, right? But all the others in the crowd looked at me as though I'd asked the most sinful question. And some people even came up to me after the session and said, you need to be careful about these. I said, I don't see any policemen trying to arrest me. I didn't say anything.
What crime have you committed?
I just said, do you think we have meritocracy in the GRC? The answer is no.
No, we don't.
We don't. So then, unless we have that conversation, we can't have the conversation that, you know, you're talking about, how to change these things. I suspect that the people who called out the minister were calling him out because he's Indian, and they were all Malays. This is a sad state of affairs in Malaysia. I'm probably maybe the first person who said this, I don't know. But the Indian minister speaking out about incompetence is seen as, bro, you got your job, just be thankful.
Exactly,
you're not supposed to speak up about any of these things, because if you do, you might be attacking us. If we go down, if we maintain this, we cannot improve. We just cannot. But we need to have more Malaysians to speak up, not on racial grounds, on the grounds that to be better, we need to have the best people in the country to do this. We'll be right back.